remember what it was like to be a kid on a summer night? A chorus of crickets plays in the air as you run through the grass in pursuit of this tiny blinking light. You're chasing fireflies. You finally cup one in your hands and your heart races as its little legs tickle your palm. You stop and marvel at its yellow glow against your fingers. Can you feel the distance between that time and now? It used to be so much easier as a kid to get lost in wonder. As adults, we forget to be curious. We feel we can't afford the space or the time. We think we should be supplying the answers rather than asking the questions. Now, this transition happens to all of us slowly over time, but I think I really noticed it in myself shortly after graduation. So fresh out of school, I accepted an entry-level video editing position at NASA Goddard. And also at this time, I was living off half of my salary to pay down my student loans. So I couldn't afford a car. I'd commute an hour and a half each way on the sweaty DC metro. And my lunches were mostly rice, and my phone was held together with tape. I worried about my situation constantly, as if that little bit of extra mental effort was somehow going to just solve my problems. And then one day, I saw the light. It was the sun. In a video, a coworker had asked me to look over, and I found that in looking at the image, watching its golden loops shimmer and spark, suddenly, the pile of work, the sad lunch, the general feeling of overwhelm, all fell away. I think the first thing I said when I finally regained the ability to speak was, "We need to give this experience to everyone." The challenge was, though, that this footage is data. Scientists use it to study the sun. But I thought, if we could change our perspective and shape this material into art, it could be so much more. You see, people tend to think of art and science as opposing forces, but really, they're both forms of exploration. So I started to wonder, could we create a space with science and art where we would allow ourselves to feel curious again? So what would this special space for exploration look like? Well, first, let's start with those two things adults feel they lack, time and space. First, let's make some space. We'll dedicate a literal room, even a single wall will do. Next, we'll project video on this wall as big as possible. Now, one of the things that I love about video editing is that it will let us play with our perception of time by speeding up or slowing down real-time events. So now we have space and we have time. So let's add some wonder, something familiar that we can observe in a new sense-engaging way. This brings us to Solarium. Solarium is a large-scale video art project that wants to take over big public walls and let you have a chance to connect with the sun in an all-new way. And I say all-new because if you've ever tried to look directly into the sun, I'm sure it didn't take you long to figure out that's a terrible idea. It's bright, painful, even dangerous. Clearly, our human eyes alone are not up to the task. So let's take a look at how technology can help us witness something awe-inspiring. Meet NASA's SDO, the Solar Dynamics Observatory. Surprisingly adorable for a spacecraft, don't you think? But what's really intriguing about it isn't how it looks, but rather how it sees. So our human senses, they exist only within a certain range. Dogs can hear in frequencies humans can't, and elephants can feel subtle vibrations in the earth. An SDO can see in the extreme ultraviolet. So what does that mean? It means that SDO can see in wavelengths of light emitted by the sun that are invisible to our human eyes. So here are some images that show how SDO sees the sun. These are the different wavelengths. Scientists have assigned different colors to these wavelengths to help them tell them apart. And each one reveals different detail about the sun. Now, detail with SDO is truly remarkable. The images it creates are huge. They're over 4,000 pixels by 4,000 pixels square. So this is bigger than 4K, bigger than your TV at home, which is probably about the size of one of those smaller boxes shown here. And while I'm using standard video dimensions for comparison, SDO actually functions much more like a flipbook than a streaming video camera. So simply put, here's how SDO works. Once every 12 seconds, the spacecraft makes an observation of the sun. And then it sends all of that data right here down to Earth, where a data visualizer takes all of that data and turns it into thousands of images. And then finally, a multimedia producer, like me, takes all of those thousands of images and turns them into footage like this. So notice how that little bit of color, cropping, and contrast really brings the image to life. But that's not science. That's art. So what would happen if we turned up the art just a little bit? So the footage you just saw and content like it is routinely made into videos for web and news broadcast. But if you're watching it on a screen, chances are you're multitasking. You're reading your mail, you're checking the news, and you're chatting with a friend all at the same time. But what you're not doing is being mindful, present, or making room for inspiration. So to let that solar footage spark some creativity, we need to take the sun off your phone or TV screen and let it illuminate a wall 40 feet high. Because at that scale, trust me, you'll have no problem being brought into the moment. A friend told me that while watching Solarium, she felt like she was a drop of rainwater that had joined an ocean. And that sense of peace, that feeling connected to something bigger, is actually very powerful. You see, art that depicts nature impacts us not just on an emotional level, but on a biological one as well. Research shows that patients that view nature images recover more quickly from surgery, have lower blood pressure, and higher pain tolerance. So if images like these can calm and heal, imagine what something like Solarium could do in public spaces or stressful environments. After all, our connection to these images is completely natural. Humans are made of the same elements that form in the interiors of collapsing stars. As Carl Sagan told us, we are made of star stuff. What we are not, however, is the center of the universe. When we get lost in worry, it's easy to feel as if everything revolves around us. But the greater, larger picture does not. And that's okay. It means we can afford a moment to take a deep breath, open our eyes, and simply explore. As adults, we are less inclined to be curious. We're not likely to go back to spending our summer evenings catching fireflies. But through the combination of science and art, what we can recapture is our sense of wonder. And what would happen if we gave ourselves permission to let in that light? Thank you.